Hi students, today we are going to learn the experiment observation of onion peel cells. Onion is an underground modified stem. Onion cells or plant cells, in this there is a presence of cell wall, there is a large central vacuole and peripheral nucleus. Aim to prepare temporary mount of onion peel cell. Apparatus: onion, glycerin, saffron in solution, dropper, forceps, water, cover slip, glass lights, needle and brush, watch glass, blotting paper and microscope. To conduct this experiment, we need to follow the procedure. At first, we have to take an onion. Now cut the onion leaf with the help of a sharp blade like this. And remove the leaf peel with the help of forceps. Now from this peel, we have to take out the onion peel. With alpha forceps, now the onion peel is placed on glass light. Now put a drop of water on the onion peel. The stain with saffronin. The saffronin absorbs by the plant cells, cytoplasm. Cover the onion peel with cover slip. The extra stain, we keep the blotting paper on the edges of the cover slip. By doing like this, then extra stain will be removed. Now the section is ready. Then place this onion peel section under the microscope. Now place the slide under the microscope on the stays of the microscope and hold this slide with clips. Oh children, what do you observe under the microscope? Yes, in this onion peel, the cells are regularly packed with a definite cell wall. Under the cell wall or below the cell wall, there was a presence of plasma membrane and there is a large central vacuole, and in this prominent nucleus, the nucleus, it pushes in one side. The nucleus pushes in one side due to the presence of large central vacuole and very pale color of cytoplasm. Children, I evaluate 2 or 3 questions. So now ready to answer. How are the cells in an onion peel arranged? Anyone guess the answer for this question? The cells in an onion peel are arranged side by side with a prominent nucleus. Are all the cells in an onion similar? Yes, please. Give the answer for this question. Yes. All the cells in an onion peel appear to be similar under the microscope.
Hi children. Today we are performing an experiment of biology of class 9th. Temporary mount of human cheek cells. Objective: to prepare strained temporary mount of human cheek cells. Materials required: glass slides, cover slip, watch glass, forceps, needle, brush, methylene blue solution, distilled water, filter paper, glycerin, toothpick or ice cream stick, dropper, microscope. Procedure: gently scrape the inner side of cheek by using ice cream stick, which we collect some cheek cells. Place the cells on the glass side that has water on it. Mix the water and the cheek cells with the help of a needle and spread them. Take few drops of methylene blue solution using a dropper and add this to the mixture on the slide. After 2 to 3 minutes, remove any excess water or methylene blue solution and strain from the slide by using a blotting paper. Take a few drops of glycerin and add to this test mixture. Take 2 to 3 drops of glycerin using a dropper and add to this to the test mixture. Take a clean cover slip and lower the cover slip slowly with the help of a needle. By using a needle, press the cover slip gently and spread the epithelial cells. Remove any extra strain or water present around the cover slip with the help of a blotting paper. Place this glass slide on the stage of the compound microscope and view it. Place the glass slide on the stage of the compound microscope and view it. Observations: a large number of flat and irregular shaped cells are observed. The cells do not have a cell wall, have a thin cell membrane. A deeply strained nucleus is observed at the center of the cell. No prominent vacuole is observed in these cells. Conclusion: the cells what we observed do not have a cell wall nor a permanent vacuole. The cells of this specimen on the slides are confirmed as animal cells. Precautions: do not scrape the cheeks too hard as it may injure your buccal mucus. Scrapped material should be spread uniformly on the slide. Excess of strain should be drained off. There should be no air bubble under the cover slip. Ensure toothpick or ice cream spoon used to scrape the cheek is clean, so it does not cause any infection to the cheek. Now we will evaluate the experiment by asking some questions. First question: what are the features we observed the cells to determine it is an animal cell? A. No cell wall, no vacuole, there is no cell membrane, both A and B. Can you guess the answer? Yes, the answer is D. Now, question number 2. Which chemical is used in this experiment to stain the cheek cells? A. Iodine, B. Copper sulfate, C. Sodium hydroxide, D. Methylene blue. Can you guess the answer? Yes, the answer is D.